He will not use the rope-a-dope. He will fight in ring center. He will go after Speaks early. But if he has to, he says he can still survive for 15 rounds. Again, we'll find out about that. In the meantime, what is the young fighter thinking? We know what Ali is thinking. He has been through this kind of crowd crush before. He says, when I leave after this fight, boxing will be a forlorn thing. He is probably right. He has been a giant. So as he goes into that ring, the crush of the crowd around him, but protected by what appears to be, at this moment, adequate security, the young fighter, the fighter who has to be equally tense, maybe even more so, has to wonder, was it luck the last time? Was that the real Ali? A man with only 8 professional fights, no matter how you slice it. 5 knockouts over nobodies, a struggle to a draw with Scott Ledoux, coming from behind to win a close decision over Rigetti, and then the astonishing victory over that man, Ali. Spinks has to be doing a lot of thinking. Leon says he has a surprise for Ali. He indicates or implies that he has changed his style. There is Ali, the face in a frown. He has been subdued. He has been sober. There has been little or no clowning. He has been all purpose for this one. And now the struggle goes greater to get to the ring. The walk seems almost interminable. He has this crowd. He knows it. He is the one they want to see. He is the storyline. And he has been a storyline for his whole life. A man in the age of the most traveled statesman of our time, Henry Kissinger, who was perhaps even more traveled, perhaps even better known. That is part of why he is a giant, a positive legend. And he has made it to the ring. And the uproar is deafening. Listen.
Championship boxing from New Orleans is being Kaiser, the king of beers. Relax with the easy taste of Bud when you say...
In the Superdome, the classic face still unmarked. No longer so youthful, no longer so naive. The din has not subsided. It has been an extraordinary thing. And now, here comes the young WBA heavyweight champion of the world, Leon Spinks. His protection... Defeat to that scene where he rushed across the ring, leveled Soria with the right, showed his comeback capacity, and showed, too, not just his stamina, but his retention of the big punch, even after being beaten up himself. And so, Leon Spinks is approaching the ring. Again, the approach to the ring is interminable. The place is a positive madhouse. Today, there was a front page story in the New York Times, in the New Orleans Times Picayune, in which it quoted Robert Arum, the promoter, as asking for the National Guard to be called out to protect against any possibility of riot within this arena. The governor of Louisiana said, no, no, it is not necessary, and we certainly hope it will not be. But this crowd is going absolutely wild as they pour in on the fighter, and his walk seems absolutely endless to the arena itself. The ring is a 20-foot ring. The fighters, of course, will be using 8-ounce gloves. A 20-foot ring, as we noted earlier in the telecast, gives one ample room to maneuver. He is almost at the ring. Ali is quiet, stoic, talking to Bandini and listening to Dundee. No histrionics from Ali. Now, Spinks continues up to the ring steps. There he goes, getting helped up now by his bodyguard. Leon Spinks, the heavyweight champion of the world, the gap-toothed fighting Marine from Camp Lejeune, who proved himself to the whole world. He is hugging Marvin Stinson, a youngster who dreamed of winning an Olympic gold medal but didn't make it. There he is, smiling, and I think covering a great sense of nervousness at this moment. If not, he would not be human. We'll be back.
You're looking at a few reasons why some young fans...
back at the Superdome, New Orleans, Louisiana, live as this simply amazing scene continues.
Ladies and
crowd unending in its roar. The ring announcer.
Let us stand for the national anthem as sung by one of the greatest of all heavyweight champions, Joe Frazier.
Michael Spinks, Leon's brother, who won the gold medal in the middleweight classification in Montreal. Michael Spinks is in Leon Spinks' corner as we look at Muhammad Ali. Joe Frazier leaving the ring. Quite frankly, we had expected another scene from Joe Frazier. We thought he was going to go over to Muhammad Ali. Let's hear the ring announcer.
Louisiana Sports, Eddie Bryant, Don Hubbard, Sherman Copeland, Philip Ciasio, and Jake DiMaggio, in cooperation with Top Rank, present a 15-round contest for the championship of the world. The judges for tonight's contest are Ernest Cojo and Herman Dutrex. The referee for tonight's contest is Lucian Jurpak. Counting for the knockdowns are Chili Fiore and the Time People Large Flurry. Supervisor of ring officials, former great featherweight contender, Jimmy Perry.
Champ Clark.
Tonight's bouts.
That's his name. The ring announcer.
Of the Louisiana State Athletic Commission, headed by Emil Bruno. Secretary Treasurer Otis Fiche, Vice Chairman Lindsay Williams.
Remember, number scoring in this one will be on a rounds basis,
Edwards,
as in New York, not on the 10-point must scoring system. Rounds basis.
Stevenson, Champ Clark, and Hess Curry presenting the challenger of tonight's bout, the former two-time great champion from Louisville, Kentucky, in white trunks, weighing in at 221, Muhammad Ali, the greatest.
Notice no expression from Muhammad Ali. No clowning, all business.
Dressed in scarlet and gold, the heavyweight champion of the world, Leon Spinks.
He takes off his robe. You'll see what I mean by tempered steel. That's his brother Michael Spinks behind him. Again, the scene in the huge Superdome. 70,000 people. A $5 million gate. Is hugged by his brother Michael. That was a landmark in Montreal, the two of them sticking together. Muhammad Ali, Bundini in front of him, quiet in his corner, taking the whole scene in. Oh, clowning. A final word with Angelo Dundee. Encouragement from the man who's been with him, who trained him, who taught him. Leon Spinks is in prayer. When do you remember Ali like that before a fight? It is built up, I think, to everything that the crowd expected by way of pre-fight tension and anticipation, and the crowd manifests that fact. A problem in Leon Spinks's corner. I can't figure it out. So far, no evidence of a brown bottle. And we'll stay on top of that for you. Now they meet in ring center. The referee, Kimba, Lucien Joubert, the judges, Ernest Cojo, Herman Dutre. Frank, knockdown rule is waived.
The second round.
punches there, but where is his left jab? He punches downward futilely with the right. There's the left jab, but with no sting. That's the blow he's got to use to keep Spinks off him. He is, oh, so easy to hit, Ali said before the fight. But so far, he has not really hit him. And there is Spinks hauling him, swinging him around. Spinks at 201, Ali at 221. And Spinks with a smile again, saying, come on. The clicking left into Spinks' face. It's there. For the first time, Ali with a couple of lefts and a right in combination. For the first time, round two, less than a minute to go. Punching downward like that, Ali has been futile. Spinks has been effective in that bomb and in ducking, putting the head down. 40 seconds left in the second round. Spinks said he would bob and weave in this fight, thus diminishing the easy target he has been in the past. There Ali scored with a left and a right. In the second half of this round, Ali has begun to put some punches together. 15 seconds left as you're counting down in the second round. Clearly an improved round for Ali. Overhead shot, the start of round three. Ali up and dancing on his feet from 20 seconds before the start of the round on. Ali, who started to put punches together in the second half of round two. No rope-a-dope, no giving away the round. Ali on most scorecards at ringside won the second round. That's unofficial, of course. Unofficial scorecards at ringside. Now Ali seeking to call upon all his guile, all his experience, the youngster seeking to go after him, feeling that Ali cannot hurt him. Ali missing as again, look how he goes down. Spinks, how he crouches, and Ali hits over him. Spinks has been effective with that crouch in a defensive sense. But in a defensive sense, Ali trying there with a combination. This is third round action. You've ever seen. This is not the old Ali, but how could it be? He is 36 and he misses so often, but he's also scoring more. And so far, Spinks has not been able to connect. Ali using the left partly to keep him off, and Ali slipping punches just out of range, dancing. Three rounds in a row on his toes. And then after throwing combinations, clinching. The end of round three coming up. Let's go to Frank Gifford and Sly Stallone.
Howard, with Sylvester Stallone and Leon Spinks, just about lived your movie Rocky last winter. Have you ever felt such electricity, excitement?
No, never, and I've seen many, many fights, but this fight seems to have an air of intensity about it, an intelligence. Every fight, I mean, every punch, every movement seems to be calculated to land. There's no wasted energy. I don't know if people probably can't see on the television, but ringside, the intensity in the eyes, this is almost like a mathematically precision type fight. I'm extraordinarily interested.
Fascinating, these two men. There you go. Okay, we're ready to go again. We're going to enjoy it. Let's go back to Howard.
Okay, Frank. I agree with you, Sly, about the intensity. But however calculated the punches may be, they are not connecting that often or effectively. Round four. Ali against Leon Spinks.
He's got left out there.
Leon Spinks, basically wild and uncontrolled, but more controlled than I've ever seen him before. Bobbing and weaving, as he suggested he might do. Using a crouch. Ali sometimes having the punch downward. Ali staying on his toes. Says he's conditioned himself to fight. Not just lost weight, but is ready to fight 15 rounds. Spinks after Ali against the ropes. Ali clinching and getting away from the ropes. More difference in strategy in these early rounds. It must be stressed. Spinks missing with that right. If Ali were really sharp with his combinations and with his left, heaven knows what he might be doing. They're in a clinch. Down. He is not effective. Halfway through the fourth round, the intensity, as Sly Stallone put it, remains. But now, Spinks after Ali. Spinks connecting. Spinks scoring with the right. And with Ali's back to us, it may be that he hurt Ali. It is hard to tell. The great aggressor all over Ali. And Ali appears perfectly composed. However, he's in the corner against the ropes where he doesn't want to be. And it is Spinks who is setting the tone for the fight. Clearly, at this point, live from the Superdome in New Orleans, Louisiana. That's scored by Ali. We are coming to the end of round four. And that one flurry by Spinks. There, two lefts. This round, Spinks has begun to get to Ali. Ali has not been able to slip the punches as he did in the prior rounds. The end of the round coming up. Maybe he is, but clearly in the fourth round, Spinks started to come on. Now in the fifth round, let's see if Ali can sustain in the sense of slipping Spinks' punches and can start to put his combinations together even more. In my opinion, the great excitement has been the crowd. More than the quality of the bout. Subjective opinion. We're almost a minute into round five, and Ali keeping Spinks at bay with the flicking left, which half the time has not been hitting. You saw Ali miss with the left. Spinks on the inside, connected with the left. A minute 10 seconds gone in round five. Five 35 years in sports, I have never heard a crowd like this. Never. Ali with a left to the head. Ali with a left and a right and a left and a right. Ali scoring well. Spinks missing. Spinks wildly trying to get in, but it was Ali who landed the cleaner punches. In fact, his best flurry of the evening. This is round five. Spinks scored with a good left. Ali trying to cover up. In this round by far than he was in the last. Ali punching with him. Spinks with a good, fine counter right. He is hurt. Ali, this fight picks up its pace. Now it's a good action fight. Remember, Leon Spinks is unafraid. He is impervious, or so it seems to be. Ali in the center of the ring, willing to go at it with him. What a difference from the beginning of the last fight, when Ali conceded the early rounds with the rope-a-dope. We're counting down to the end of round five, and they went at each other in this round. Six between rounds, you can hear what they were being told, the fighters in their respective corners. Sam Solomon was exhorting Leon Spinks. He's got to get inside, and he's got to be effective on the inside. Ali fighting infinitely more effectively in the early rounds this time than he did the last time, when, as we have stressed, he was using just the rope-a-dope. You saw the right uppercut, and it got to Spinks. In ring center, Ali on his toes, balance. Spinks always pursuing, but Ali flicking the left. Remember, Ali with the right lead is extremely effective, always has been, but it's a dangerous punch. Ability to take a punch, part of his legend as a fighter. How he drew upon every last resource in Manila against Joe Frazier. Apparently done in at the end of round 10, he came back big. Spinks is wildly pursuing Ali. He's not doing it with any evidence of boxing skill. Just pursuing. A tough kick. Doesn't know how to stop. Ali with a good right. Ali dancing. Ali with a good left and dancing away. Spinks pursuing, but puzzled, not scoring. Ali growing in his confidence and growing in his willingness to mix it up. It's a tactical fight by Muhammad Ali up to this point. Not by Leon Spinks, who has never been called a tactical fighter. Ali with the two quick left jabs, a third, a fourth, dancing, fifth, sixth, seventh, scoring with the left. Spinks finally with a left. Spinks wildly after Ali. Spinks balling. 20 seconds, and you see it in the lower right-hand corner, counting down. Ali clinching with the younger man. End of the round, almost upon us. Live for round 7, the deafening din continues. Ali against Spinks. Quickly with a couple of lefts. Ali with two flicking lefts that land only glancingly, but they do land. and presumably they score. Spinks trying to get in, trying to score. But Ali, with all of his years of experience, apparently in far better condition than in his last fight against Spinks, using that experience, relying upon it. Spinks in that crouch, and Ali punching downward. Again, Deuce flicking left jabs. 1 minute into the seventh round. Spinks trying desperately to connect, to hurt the former champion. Spinks with a good right. The upper shoulder and neck as he had Ali against the ropes. The one place Ali doesn't want to be, against those ropes. This is not George Foreman. This is not 1974. This, says Ali, is no time for the rope-a-dope. Spinks with a left that landed. The right did not. Seventh round action. Got ticked off by Spinks's glove. A minute to go in the seventh round. Good flurry of combinations by Ali, setting the kid up for them. A good flurry of combinations by Muhammad Ali. In round seven, and Ali is still on his toes. You can see him bouncing, moving. Part of Spinks's problem. A right by Spinks glanced along Ali's chin, the left side of his chin. You see the count down to the end of round seven. Spinks has scored very little in this fight.
WBC heavyweight champion. Larry, your thoughts so far?
Well, Ali's here. He's doing a real good job. He's boxing Spinks. All he has to do now is hold it, maintain his boxing. Spinks can't win this fight if Ali can keep it.
You said something to me. Every time Spinks went into that crouch, Ali was doing what?
Throwing the left hook and the right hand. See, when Spinks go into the crouch, he comes up. Ali jabs, Spinks duck, comes back up. He's open for the right hand, and Ali is bonding for that. Vulnerable for that, so all he got to do is keep doing what he's doing, and he might stop this guy.
I know you're enjoying it. You've lost your voice. Larry Holmes, now back to you, Howard.
Thank you, Frank. Holmes is right, of course, and his appraisal of the fight thus far is right. Remember, Larry is the WBC heavyweight champion. He won that thriller over Kenny Norton last June in Las Vegas. Ali is outboxing Spinks, using his movement, his wisdom, his experience. But it's only the eighth round. When Spinks goes into that crouch, Ali would do well to punch upward with the uppercut rather than downward if he can. Spinks missed with his left. Ali connected with his counter left. 45 seconds into round eight. Round eight. Good left to the right by Ali. That shook Spinks up. Spinks comes right back trying. But it was Ali who scored. Clean blows. Good left-right combination. Oh, that time, Spinks got through to Ali with a left and a right when he had him against the ropes. chance of being an extraordinary champion, or certainly a very good one. It's giving young Leon Spinks a boxing lesson up to this point. But that's the perspective on this fight as of now. Round nine. See that left? Again, the combination. Spinks, as you could see there, missing. Ollie's head out of range. The left and in the crouch. If Ali ever comes up with a right uppercut, Spinks will know it. Spinks got in a good left there, but his scoring has been few and far between. Ali in ring center, not dancing now, standing flat footed, ready to mix it up. A change of pace, maybe an evidence of some fatigue, hard to tell. But Ali is not setting the pace at the moment. Right there, he ganked with the combination. But he is clinching more in this round so far. With a minute 45 in a corner. Again, Ali with the left. Spinks trying to counter with the right. Having all kinds of trouble. Punching down, Ali has trouble. We'd like to alert our local stations along the line that at the end of this round, we'll take a station break. Again, you saw Ali miss, punching down. Ninth round action. 35 seconds left. Ali with a quick combination, another left. Ali cut back on his pace a bit in this round. Spinks scoring with a right. Now there's a little more movement, but there he is, flat-footed again, and using the left defensively. The end of the round. Well, championship boxing from the Superdome in New Orleans after this from our local station. 15 rounds. The commission checked the contents of the brown bottle in Leon Spinks's corner. Apparently found nothing undue. 10th round action. Ali in command of the fight. Boxing like that with the quick combinations. Scoring repeatedly. Pacheco, Ali's former doctor, sitting behind me, saying to me between rounds, I didn't believe that he could still come up with this kind of effort. So far, he has. It's been the hallmark of his career. Even a little bit of a shuffle. That shows you how he feels. He's in command of this fight. He reverts back to the shuffle. But not scoring. Ali, so purposeful. sure of himself. What an extraordinary career. What an extraordinary man he has been in every way. Dancing now, and it's the 10th round. No evidence of fatigue. As this round ends, we're going to go to Leon Spinks's corner and see what, if anything, Sam Solomon can tell him. Spinks is tired. Ali is there with the combinations. And the pattern is now clear. This fight has taken form. Okay, the end of round 10. The crowd unendingly on its feet. Look at that mob. And now, let's look at Leon Spinks. Let's see if we can hear it.
Push.
The guy ain't even there, and you ain't doing nothing about it. You're right in front of him, and you're not doing nothing to him.
Come on, Leon.
Leon. The guy is there.
Hold it up.
Leon. Yes, Leon.
You got to go.
Get off.
Got to go.
You gotta get off.
Not against Young, not against Shavers, not against Evangelista, and not against Spinks the last time. But this time, yes, he hit Spinks with a good right there. 11th round action. Spinks, look at Ali. That's Ali. The right had connected, and he played a little bit of possum, like the old Ali. I'm not telling you, he is nearly as good as he was, nor would he, 3-4 years ago. But he is doing what he has to do against this opponent. Now Spinks is trying to strike back. It is the 11th round, and Spinks has a long way to go, according to most of the scoring here at ringside, unofficial scoring. Tying them up. Lucien Joubert separating the fighters. Good right by Ali after a left leg. Hurt Spinks. In the first two rounds, Ali seemed off in his timing, was missing frequently. I thought it might be a telltale sign.